This is a meditation to help you with relationships. Relationships with yourself and others. This is a meditation to help you disconnect from unhealthy karma that has kept you from having healthy relationships and making room for more healthy connections. Begin by making yourself comfortable. Find any position you're comfortable in and begin to focus on your breath. Take long, slow, deep breaths. Breathe in through your nose. Breathe out through your mouth. Just breathe and relax. Relax and breathe. Follow your breath as it goes deep, deep, deep into your lungs, filling and expanding them with air. Exhale and follow the breath as it slowly leaves your body through your mouth. In and out you breathe, easily, effortlessly, all focus remaining on your breath, entering and exiting your body in an endless cycle. Feel yourself sliding comfortably and easily into a state of complete and deep relaxation. Feel a sense of deep peace filling your entire being. Feel the joy that just is breathing. Deeper and deeper and deeper you go into a state of total, blissful, complete relaxation. Easily and effortlessly, you just relax and go deeper into a state of being where healing takes place. Relax. Breathe. Relax. Breathe. Now, visualize yourself in a clearing in a forest. The clearing is light and warm. You see or sense your angels and guides all around you. You feel comfortable, safe, and protected. In the center of the clearing, you see a strange shimmering light in the fabric of the air. You walk over to it and examine it. It appears to be a doorway or a portal. You stick your foot in and pull it out again. It seems safe. You notice that you now have cords extending from your feet deep into the earth and all the way up to the heavens, as far as you can see. You are now firmly connected to the earth plane. It is safe to step through the portal, and you decide to do so. You step through, and when you do, you see a slide in front of you. You decide to slide. It's fun. At the bottom of the slide, you see a playground. There are children playing. You hear their laughter. You look more closely at them. They're so happy and innocent at play. You watch for a moment. You see one child who looks familiar. You step closer. The child smiles and greets you. And now you remember. It is you. It is your inner child, long forgotten. You are excited to have found each other again. It's been a long time. You remember being so happy and loving and carefree. You feel a sense of joy at this remembrance. child takes you by the hand and points to what appears to be another portal. You walk over to it, and you both step through and slide down the slide. You look around. You are in a classroom. Students who appear to be in their late teens or early 20s sit at desks. A teacher is at the front of the room. The teacher nods to one particular student, and that person stands up. It is you. You remember being full of hopes, dreams, and ambitions. You remember being so full of life. You greet each other happily. It's been a long time. All of the students now point in the direction of what appears to be another portal. You and the child and the student take each other's hands and slide through together. Three of you have now come to a place that appears to be ancient. It feels like home to you. Let your subconscious mind reveal this place fully to you. Maybe there are ruins. Maybe there is water. Maybe there are stairs. Or something else. Whatever and whomever is there, see, feel, and hear this ancient place in any way that your mind and spirit directs you. Just delight in this ancient place and this ancient civilization. Soon, you see an interesting, shimmering, glowing light coming toward you. As it approaches, you notice it is made up of many colors and multiple layers. It is beautiful. You study this light configuration more closely. You have a knowing that this is you. This is your soul, long forgotten. You feel a sense of wonder and amazement at how light and beautiful you really are. Your soul guides the three of you to a room. It is, among other things, a viewing room. There is a large, circular projection screen on the wall. The room is comfortable and nice. Your soul imparts to you that you and your forgotten selves that you have just collected are disconnected from each other, and you all must merge in order to be whole again. So just as you stepped easily into the portal, now simply step easily into your soul. First, your inner child. Then, your student self. And now, your current self. Merge all of your forgotten selves with your soul. You are now whole again, and that feels wonderful to you. You now realize that in order to have healthy relationships, you must first be whole and complete. No one else can complete you. Contemplate this for a few moments. Now, you look around the room and you notice what appears to be a control panel with cords and plugs that look like electrical cords sticking in and out of it. The cords are all different. Some are brightly colored, others are muted, but most of them are all rather messy, long and extended. Some are even entangled with other cords. They are all labeled. Some are labeled karmic cords. Others are labeled soul connection cords. The soul connection cords are fine. You don't have to do much with these right now. The soul connections are gold. Touch one. And as you do, you feel a sense of love flowing through you. These are healthy connections. You touch one of the karmic cords. As you do, you see on the viewing screen the person that cord is attached to. You can see, like a movie, the lessons you have learned or are learning with this person. Of course, they are all lessons in love, even if they didn't or don't seem so. The screen turns like a wheel, and in a flash, you can see all of your interactions throughout the ages with this person. On and on, this karma has continued in the circle of life. This is why these types of connections feel so familiar, yet unresolved. Decide right now if you are done with the lesson or lessons you have engaged in with this person. The decision is about whether or not you are done with the lessons, not about whether or not you are done with this person. If you are not done with the lesson, it will simply repeat with someone else. Karma is about owing, and the way to release it is to finally come full circle. When you have truly learned the lessons in love that you have been trying to teach each other, and have stepped away from your own stubborn ego position, you know what needs to be done to end the cycle. So, decide if you owe this person an apology, or if this person owes you one. If you do, or they do, simply apologize. Thank the person, forgive them, release them, and see them doing the same with you. Now, release this lesson by simply unplugging that karmic cord. It's so easy. Just reach over and unplug it. You are free from this lesson now, and free from your karmic connection to this particular person. Know that you can come back to this room anytime you like and unplug any other karmic connection you feel done with. This makes room for more healthy soul connections to enter your life. For now, you are done here. Step out of the room and back into the comfort and familiarity of the ancient civilization. You feel so at home. You feel so free. You feel so whole, complete, and unburdened. You look around and you see another portal. You step through and slide, slowly, slowly this time, right back to your physical awareness, feeling refreshed, content, and more connected than you've ever felt before. Remember, you can always return whenever you feel the need for connection.